Hey there, this is Dalton Quigley. I showed you the design that I designed and I showed you how everything was laid out. Let's take a look now at the finished job.
So, right back here, the bed starts. We put in our hollies. There's three hollies right there. And then we have three endless summer hydrangeas. So on this side, we pretty much just put in the endless summer hydrangeas and the hollies. Then here, this beautiful plant on the corner is a Hinoki Cypress Melody, M-E-L-O-D-Y. Take a look at the bark down there. It's really neat. It's gonna get maybe a foot or two taller and there'll be no trimming ever. It's just an amazing plant. If you look at it, it's got lots of gold and green, and in certain places, there's a little bit of blue under the leaves. It just has a really great look. So that's the Hinoki Cypress that we put in. And then as we work our way around over here, I've added another boulder there, a boulder there. On the side, we have three gardenias, one right there, there, and there. They were cut back recently, so they're a little smaller. There's a dwarf Alberta, and then three more endless summer hydrangeas. So let's stand back. Gardenias, dwarf Alberta, and endless summer hydrangeas. And now let's go take a look in the back. The purpose for how things were designed was to give this client a little privacy. So let's take a look at what they look at out their backyard. This is such a popular little city to move into. The building here is going on like crazy. So when you look past their fence, all you see are houses going up. And then back in that direction, all that land is scheduled for new houses as well. So to the right and left, our neighbors, straight across the back, our neighbors. It's just really intense with building. So let's come back over here about where they're going to sit and see why things were designed the way they were. So when they're sitting here, as those fill in, they're going to get a foot or two wider and taller. This is going to be a nice cozy spot from the right, and over to the left, the way that landscape is designed, when they get a little bit bigger, that's going to fill in right there and give them privacy. There's a screen there with those arborvitae, and then there's a screen there with those three, because the plants that are down below are going to get a little bit bigger, and those are going to fill in a little bit. That's not going to be super dense screen, but that's some sense of enclosure. So let me show you a couple of the highlights of back here. Right here I have a green mountain boxwood. Over on the other corner is another green mountain boxwood. So that frames the patio. Right here is a coral bark Japanese maple, Sango Kaku, and that's the color of the bark. And these are Liberty Hollies. They're beautiful. This is what the leaf looks like on Liberty Hollies. And over here we have our vintage jade distillium. So they get 3 to 4 feet tall. They mound and have weepy branches. It's going to be so cool when they get a little bit bigger. And then here are our drift roses, our red drift roses. So they get about a little bit taller than knee high when they fill in. And so there's five here, three there. So when you're standing on the porch, you've got color to the right and the left, and three right there. And this bed is planned, the client loves to plant her own irises. So she's gonna put some irises here. And also there's some drift roses down there. But here I've got skipped laurels that go right in between, staggered in between the hollies to give some screening. And this is what the job looks like. Oh, and boulders, by the way. There's a boulder over there, a boulder over there, and then another boulder over here by the Japanese maple. I'm gonna stand out and then kind of pan around so you can see. So there's the project all completed. Thank you for looking at one of my jobs, and I hope you guys have a great day. Bye-bye.